What's up, Pinoy? What's up with my Pinoy? Hey, I swear to God, though, I'm nervous in the mother. And Rome done coached me a little bit, so if I do good, he gets the credit. But if I mess up, it still gets the credit. So I'm, first of all, I just want to give a shout out to all you beautiful people that's here today to allow me to come up to share with you guys a story, one Filipino man's story. Me being here, I never thought I'd be here. But look what has God made to happen. Everybody who's here, y'all belong here. Because the God I serve, he don't make no accidents. And it ain't no coincidence or accident that you here today. So give yourself a hand for that. Because of something that's here that hopefully inspires you to do something better in life. And I really hope that I touch somebody's heart. Because I want to speak to your heart. I'm going to speak from my heart to your heart. And if you don't mind, I'll share. Because what I'm here to talk about is that. Who are you? When I was my son's age, I had an identity crisis growing up. I'm born and raised in the South of Market. Y'all ever heard of South of Market in San Francisco? That's right. I'm born there. I still live off of 6th Street. Y'all know how it is over there. 6th Street, Tenderloin. Ain't nothing tender about the lawn. You know, and it's like that song, The Message. Y'all heard that song, Melly Mel? He says, broken glass everywhere. People pissing on the station like just don't care. I can't stand the smell, I can't take the noise, but we ain't got no money to move out because we ain't got no choice. Rats in the front room, roaches in the back, junkie in the alley with the baseball bat. Don't we go through that every day, you guys? That's my son right there. Last year at this time, one of his homeboys got murdered. Josiah, may he rest in peace. He carried the casket for one of his homeboys his age, 17 years old at the time. Imagine 17 years old, you having to deal with death. 2 weeks later, which is in February of last year, and I hate to put you on blast, but this truth, this real a real story, and I'm gonna keep it 1 million with y'all. My son got stabbed up. He almost died. He wouldn't have even been here if it wasn't for the grace of God, but he made it. And so watch this. They told you I've been doing work as a United player. And United players, we ain't talking about the players with all the money or all the jewels or all the females. Those players are played out. I'm talking about the players that's doing something positive and productive for their people in the community or the hood and saving lives. That's real talk. We stepping our game up. We used to take life. But now we bring in life, and it starts one time, it starts one person at a time, but it starts from you. And so let me get back to my son. Last year at this time, right, when he got stabbed up, I've been doing this work for 23 years. 23 years I'm out here helping other people's kids out and saving people's lives. And relatively, I'm 7 out of 10. You know, I'm pretty good. That's like 7 free throws out of 10. That's better than half and half. So, my son, I got a phone call, I'm riding down the street, driving my daughter off. Well, picking her up, driving her back to the center that we on. And the phone rings, and I ain't even told you this story, but you finna hear it. They said, are you Rudy Corpuz Jr.? Well, they didn't say Jr., they said Rudy Corpuz. I said, yeah, that's me. Well, you need to get down to General Hospital. Y'all know General Hospital is, right? It's one of the best trauma units in the world. Saved my life several times. I said, okay, what's up? You got a son named Elijah Corpuz? I said, yeah, why? Because I usually get the phone call, but it ain't my kid. And I said, yeah. They said, you need to get down there to the trauma unit immediately. I said, well, what's up? They said, you need to get down here right now. So forgetting my daughter was in the back, I'm smashing now. I got a Dodge Caravan. Y'all know them 2005s with 3 hubcaps. I'm smashing. Running and blowing through red lights. I get to the General Hospital. I jump out my whip. Won't even forget my little daughter's in the back. And how old is your sister, Elijah? 11. Get it right. She's 11 years old. She was 10 at the time. Jumped out the car, ran in the hospital. I see my son in the gurney at General Hospital, emergency unit, finna die. police around him, you know, the gang task force, they asking questions. I ran in and I seen he was alive, and I was like, oh God, he's alive at least, because sometimes they may be dead. And I swear to God, man, I was like, I was torn because of the work I do. Here I am saving everybody's life, but when it came to my son, it was a totally different feeling. And the only thing that I could think of, and I'm keeping it rated R up in here for rough, rugged, and raw, was revenge. We don't take no prisoners, right? Because I'd rather be judged by 12 than carry out by 6. Y'all might catch that. And so here I am looking at my son, and I'm thinking about revenge. And throughout the whole day, he got stabbed up like around 2 p.m., all the way from 2 p.m. to 11, all the way p.m. My phone is blowing up. And I swear to God, man, this ain't even something I wanted to talk about, but here it goes. It's ringing and ringing, and people call him, hey, Rudy, I heard your son, because, you know, bad news travel fast. We already want to go get these dudes. We want to come get them. We know where they at. We know who they at. And I'm, like, on the phone plotting. Mind you, I'm the guy that saved people's lives. When that stuff happened to my son, all that went out the window. 23 years of prevention, 23 years of saving everybody's life, didn't matter no more to me. I was on a mission, and my phone kept ringing. And I decided I'm going to pick it up one more time because it kept blowing up. That's how God worked. Watch this. And don't trip, y'all got a flip phone. It's the new i11. I keep it simple. You call me, I'll call you. You text me, I'll text you. That's it, that's all. So it's ringing. It's a number that I don't recognize. So I answer, it's 11 o'clock at night. Watch this. I said, hello? What you want? Because I'm hot, like Chinese duck grease. I'm hot. It's a woman. She says, is your name Rudy? I said, yeah. She said, don't you work with kids? I said, yeah. She said, my son is going to end up in prison or he's going to end up dead. I need your help. I said, excuse me? And I remind you now, I'm thinking of killing somebody. I heard you save people's lives. It woke my game up. God checked me. God said, you know what, man? All these years, you've been serving me, and you've been doing a good job. And now here you is, something happened. I got your son. He gonna live. Look, he's right there. He's alive. He ain't gone. And the devil almost got me for that instant. But God said, nah, I got this. And so the mother who called me, I snapped out that spell. I said, watch this. Who's your son? Where'd he go? Where he at? She said, he goes to Mission High School. I used to go to Mission High School. Never graduated, but I was there hanging out with the thugs in the yard, right? I said, okay, send him here at this day. The kid right now, right, my son lived, thank God. He didn't give him no information or whatnot, you know what I mean? Because that's the code that we live by. The guy who the mother called me for, he currently right now comes to our center, and he's seeking a job, but he's alive, y'all, and he's doing good in school, straight up. Right. And so, who are you? God has blessed you to do something great in life. How many of y'all college students here? Raise your hand. That's right. Don't think, man, I just walked the yard, man, in some of these jailhouses. I've been to college, too. Yep, I went to college, too. And I swear to God, one of the most things that I learned, and I learned this in jail, too, is to know your culture, know your history, know your people. If you want to know who you are, you got to find out what everybody did before and who was it. I ain't never knew about the dudes at the farm workers, right? What's them dudes' names, the farm workers? That was in Delano and Stockton. Y'all know any names? Philip who? Who else? I would say it, I just can't pronounce it right. Thank you. Those dudes, man, did this work way before we did this. There's people here who did work and saved lives before we did it. But we're just getting chosen. And when you're chosen by a higher power to do what you do, because you're destined in life to do something. Everybody in here is destined in life to do something. You're not no accident. You're not no coincidence. You are meant to be here regardless. You know, as Filipinos, that's one thing. We the most beautiful people on the planet. And the hardest work. Look around, look at them. Look to the next to you, look at the person next to you. Don't they look beautiful? Tell them, say next to you, you look beautiful. Hey, Chopper, tell Uncle Freddy, you was beautiful. I swear to God, regardless, us Filipinos, we're tall, we're short, we're fat, we're skinny, we're dark, we're light, right? We come from different genders, but I swear to God, y'all know what it is. We the hardest working people on the planet. We're the most committed, we got the most pride, we go hard in the paint. But we are beautiful people. We got people that make transitions on this planet, them foreign workers, man. And I hate, I ain't trying to speak bad on no other nationalities. Won't they give our Filipino props? I do, right? They got Cesar Chavez, may he do his thing. Much respect to him and the Latinos. Right? They got the blacks, they got the Malcolm X's and the Martin Luther King's. What about our Filipino people? What about our ride and die people who stood up? Our Manongs and our Manongs, right? Did I say it right, y'all? I'm learning. I'm from the hood. I'm born and raised. My motto, it takes the hood to say the hood. But it's in my heart. That's what matters. Filipino is in your heart. And so who are you? Can I share with you who y'all is? See, it ain't no accident that you here. One day, there was a million sperms that was going up to that one egg. There was some of you had to knock over, some of you had to jump over, and some of them you had to fight just to get to that one egg. And that one sperm that got to that one egg was you. So that means before you even came into this earth, before you came into this planet, when you was up in here being made because you got there first and you were flushed into this world, you didn't beat a million of them up. So you a million and oh before you even came in on this earth. So don't tell me, my Filipino people, you ain't bad. Don't tell me, my Filipino people, that you ain't tough or you not hard. You are somebody because you was meant to be here and you made it here because it could have been one of the mother sperm. So I'm just gonna finish and say this. Can y'all repeat after me? I am somebody.
I am somebody.
Come on, Pino, we gotta do a lot. I am somebody.
I am somebody.
I am brown and I am beautiful.
I am brown and I am beautiful.
I am Filipino and I am beautiful.
I am Filipino and I am beautiful.
Embrace that and don't forget that, because that's real. Thank you for having me. Let me speak, y'all. Hey, Ron, one love, baby.